Hello, Michael Zalapsky here for Make It Monday. RayGiant posted this on Instagram last week and someone asked for a tutorial. So, but I've got the guy Rotoed out here, just using AE's Rotobrush tool. So I have that guy on his own layer. Now I want this texture from the background, but on this orange solid. What I'm gonna do is very simply apply the set matte effect to this orange solid here and use the Roto with its effects and masks. And then just invert that matte. And then we'll just tuck this orange solid down there because I'm going to use the calculations effect on this layer here to grab that orange solid with its effects and masks into the scene like this. And then I just used a blending mode like color and cranked up a bit. So it gives the background the color, but it keeps the texture. And it's all on one layer. Neat. Now we need to get rid of this green, but we don't need to use something fancy like Primatic Gear. We can just use After Effects Native Color Key and crank that up. Now it's time for some fast tracking with Spot Clone Tracker. We'll track his fingers here. That seems like a good spot to track, lots of detail. And we'll set custom with the method 0 on all these things because we don't really want to remove anything. We just want the tracking data because it is faster to track than After Effects Native Tracker. And we'll use the position, scale, and rotation, and we'll track forward. Spot Clone Tracker works faster than After Effects, can even update the screen, so you won't really see much happening here. You'll just see it saying, hey, yep, I am in fact tracking. And it's tracked that little spot on his hand the whole way through. So let's make our text layer follow that tracking information. So we'll say, hey, for the position, Alt click to add an expression, and we'll say, hey, you're going to follow that spot center there, but plus value. That way we can offset however we'd like. We'll say 0, 0 for now to put it right back where that spot is. And then we'll just move it up and over. Looks like it needs a bit of rotation. So we will add that rotation in there to point to the spot, rotate plus value. And then we'll just kind of rotate however much it needs to be rotated to work here. And looks like we need to mess with our lighting there. Actually, you know what? We probably need this anchor point here to be more in the center. There we go. Make that anchor point more match where that position is. It looks like our key is not quite right. Again, we used a kind of a janky key mode. So we will grab another copy of color key. And we'll just pick this green color. It's giving us trouble. Knock that gone. Scoot the text over a little bit. All right, there you go. So now we've got the text following the phone and the guy smiling. Now, the big main part of this is getting Trapcode Particular into the mix. So we'll get a new solid layer and we will apply Trapcode Particular. We'll make a box emitter, get a lot more particles per second so we can see what we're doing. And we'll make it pretty small. And with no velocity, so we can kind of see exactly the size of our box here. And we'll make it, we'll put it over here where the phone is. So it basically fits roughly the size of the phone. We don't want it to be exact, we just want the particles to be, seem to be coming from the phone roughly. Now, to get the particles to come out and go around the person, the best way to make particles go exactly where you want them is to use motion paths. So we will make a new light and we will call this light motion path 1. And we'll add a keyframe here on frame 0 to be right where the phone is on its position. We'll go forward a bit, move the light position forward a bit, and maybe a bit over. So it kind of comes out of the phone up here, and then we'll move it over here. Yeah, that's better. Kind of come out. Then we'll go back in 3D space, forward in time, and back in space. So it goes behind the person and over a bit here. And, you know, you can tweak this motion path as things go, but I think this shape is looking pretty good. And then go ahead and we'll head off the screen here. Under our displace settings, we've got the option to do motion path on. And they follow that motion path around. But we set this motion path to be happening over 4 seconds. and the particles are not set to live that long. So we need to go back into our particle settings and say, hey, you need to live like, or you know, just 4 seconds, the length of our path. There we go. And now we see the particles on the scene. We can see that, hey, maybe we're coming a little too far forward. Let's look from the top and have a look at where our particle path is going. That seems, yes, indeed, a little extreme here. So again, we could just adjust our path to be as pleasant as we would like it to be. You know what? We need to start at zero. That's our main problem. All right, there we go. Much better particle path. Press escape to go back to the main active camera, and we'll fit it up here. Let's see, does that look better? That is better. Now we need to give those particles a little bit of randomness to their motion. So under the environment, air turbulence, we'll say, hey, you air turbulence, you could affect the position somewhat. Maybe not too much though. Just to give them a bit more movement there. And I think that works nicely, but I might make that scale maybe around 7 or so. Maybe 8. See how that looks. And then it's just a question of making our particles have the right look. For the color, we want it to be random from the gradient. And our color gradient, we want that red, green, and black. Be black. And we'll say step all. And that gives us no blending. And that's too greeny of a green. We want a darker green for this. Go and a darker red as well. And we're going to need a lot fewer particles than this. Probably more like 100 per second, perhaps. And we will need these to be not spheres. We're going to want hearts. So we say sprite, choose sprite, and I believe we've got a heart right in here for us, colored red handily. And then under our sprite controls, which have now become available since we've chosen sprite, we can say, hey, we want you to be colorized or color filled. Kind of depends on what you've got sprite wise. We also need you to be significantly larger, little particles. So bump up the size to something like 50. And yeah, it looks like we have too many particles still. Bump that down to maybe 40 per second. Now, with some of these particles being the same color, you can kind of lose the shape. So something to help you get the shape, I think I need slightly brighter red here. Slightly brighter. To help you not lose the shape of the particles of each other, we can use something called shadowlets. It's under your lighting controls. You can say, you don't want to enable the lighting, just say enable the shadowlets. And that'll put like a basic little drop shadow behind the particles. We want our opacity to be a little bit more than that so we can see it better. We don't need the size to be quite that big. And we definitely don't need it to be that far away from the particles, so maybe something like that. Now, you can take this little box here, match particle shape, and it, instead of making kind of a just random spherical little shadow, you'll get the shape of the shadow kind of more matching the particles. But either way, kind of get a bit more of an edge on your particles there. Now, we don't want them to be just popping into existence here either. We want them to kind of scale up real quick. So we'll say for the size of our particles over life, we'll start at pretty much nothing. And we'll ramp up pretty quick to being, yeah, we wanted to ramp up real quick to being a full particle size. We'll shoot right up. So there you go. Yeah, they pop right out of the phone and go around. And then to make them look like they go behind him, our roto layer needs to be a 3D layer. And we will say, hey, for your visibility, we will say this roto layer is our obscuring layer and we'll use effects and masks. And now our particles will go behind him. We'll do some quick Supercomp work here just to kind of integrate things a little nicer. Since the hearts are technically in front of him, we'll put some reverse light wrap on them. So they kind of wrap their light around him some, or at least look like they do. And we'll add some optical glow on our freedom to make it look like it's glowing off of the phone here. Probably a bit larger on the size, not too much. And definitely a lot less on the amount. We'll do a bit of color correction on them to kind of match them into the background just a touch, and we'll add some light wrap on them so they'll get the background wrapping onto them as well. Then over top of everything, we'll add an adjustment layer with Magic Bullet Looks. And in Magic Bullet Looks, we'll just add a few things real quick. A little bit of diffusion, a little bit of halation, and renoiser. Diffusion, we'll just use Pro Mist at a quarter. Halation, we'll set to be a modern 35, and renoiser, we'll also choose for modern 35. That kind of helps tie everything together with the diffusion and the grain. So there you go. Really fast way to get Trapcode Particular particles to go where you want them to go. If you have any other tutorial requests, pop them in the comments below.